Welcome back to the Kingdom Hearts 3D Dream Drop Distance Marathon presented to you by HPAW and Teclis. What are we here to do today?
We're going to finish the marathon.
All right.
Spoiler alert.
Memory Skyscraper. Remember, we just arrived in the real world that never was, and we got a real introduction with the real 3D pop-up thing that says the world that never was, and fancy.
Was it real? How deep
was everything?
Were we?
Was anything
How
ever
deep
real?
In were we?
Is anything ever real?
It's a big question.
Okay. Screw the cap. It's not the cap.
So you're still using Shadowbreaker?
Yeah.
Because I just got that.
It's pretty good. I like it. I mean, okay, let's take a look at what we can do. Like, I get rid of... Okay, I'm looking at Dark Firaga and Shadowbreaker. And I'm seeing another two...
Big attack?
Yeah, what do you think?
I agree. What else do you have?
Well, the Teclis. We have...
Aerial Slam.
Okay, we can't use those, because one of them's in use, so one of them's for Sora only. We can't use that one. Wait, really? Do we not have any other... Okay, I don't know what that's... We have Meteor. So we have Meteor and Meteor Crash.
Having two other attacks is probably cooler.
We have zero... Oh, we don't have zero gravity. When did we take zero gravity out?
That's a pretty cool attack. Not really a boss attack.
Oh, I think we took it out for a boss fight.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that's probably a good place to keep it then.
I'd probably agree.
It's probably a good place to keep it. Kira and Kiraga, I'm liking that because the Kira reloads faster. Ice Barrage takes up two slots, knocks enemies in the air by creating ice directly underneath them. I wonder if you even have to aim with that. I mean, what do you think? I think that one, maybe?
Yeah,
give
sure.
Give it a
shot? Try it out, at least.
It's a magic. We're pretty good with magic.
I think your Keyblade's better at magic.
Yeah. Just said that. Yeah, it's pretty good with magic. I have a giraffe. It's a thunder giraffe. So let's review. Sora is in trouble. Do we need any chests? That's the number one priority, actually.
No. Are we with the real Sora or are we with a dream Sora?
Not with any Sora.
The one that we're trying to get, I mean.
Well, I want real Sora. I don't know who you want to get.
Well, are we in a dream?
Well, we're... Okay, let's think about that. We still look young-ish, and we still have a dream meter symbol on our back.
Yes.
So I'm going to say yes, we're still in a dream somewhere. What does the shop have for sale? We haven't stopped by a shop in a long time, actually. Ooh! Oh! Ah, well, we totally missed out on that. We got a lot of money, though.
You can buy whatever you like.
Let's buy more Kiragas. How about, let's just buy, I don't know, let's buy five Kiragas.
You probably need five Kiragas.
Yeah. We're just not going to buy anything. Oh, you can buy a wake-up block, huh? Maybe that's why I never found it, because you can buy it in the store. You can buy, like, stuff, too. But you can't buy the really rare stuff. Maybe you can. Savage Fantasy, that's... I don't know. We're done with Dream Eaters?
I think, yeah, at this point, you're done.
Like, we're not even going to change them up for the final boss here. We're just go in. So it's between me and whoever. Oh.
Too late?
End of the road, huh? I know I'm back in the real world. But I still have my Dream Eater powers. Which means... he still hasn't woken up.
Oh.
Where are you, Sora?
So...
Huh?
So we're in the real world because Sora is still sleeping, we still are in a dream? Goes to chill, you cannot use logic. It's Kingdom Hearts.
A Dream Eater. Is that where Sora is? How do I get across?
Hey, remember the bat and the
Zubat.
Remember the ones that are like the like Sora's supposed to have that one, and Riku's got the bat one. Meow Wow, there it is.
Meow Wow's pretty good.
Meow Wow's not bad. But Meow Justy.
Better. Where did you get that one?
Got from the card, the AR card.
Oh, I didn't.
It's one. I think it's that's the one that has the three on it, so you get one of the three randomly.
Damn it. Yeah, I got a useful one, but I didn't get that one.
Well, they're all fairly useful. Or otherwise, it would be a... suck. So we're at the castle. The castle that never was. Now, how did Sora get in? Let's recall. In Kingdom Hearts 2, he got in using Kairi, giving him a signal, and he created a bridge. Using her light or whatever. We're gonna do something similar. We're gonna draw a line on the bottom screen.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Who needs Kairi anyway? Hmm. Huh. Didn't take long to get here.
Apparently.
Sora! Hands off my new vessel. Vessel? Yes. We originally had our sights set on you. But you developed a certain resistance to darkness. So we did what the Keyblade did, and moved down the list. Roxas. Now there was a worthy candidate. But, unfortunately, he became too aware of himself, and returned to Sora. Organization 13's true goal is to divide Xehanort's heart among 13 vessels. Thanks to you and Sora, we learned not all our candidates were fit for the task, but we managed to make up the difference. And now, Sora, the 13th vessel, is within our grasp.
13 Xehanorts? What is...
The real Organization 13.
The organization?
I am Xehanort from the most distant past. My future self gave me a task. To visit the splintered versions of myself in many worlds and ensure they gathered here today.
From the past?
There are restrictions to movement through time. First, you must leave your body behind to do it. Then, there must be a version of you waiting at the destination. Upon arrival, you can only move forward as per the laws of time. And you cannot rewrite the events that are destined to happen.
What have you done?
My most future self will arrive soon. Then, time for all of us will return to normal. And I will go back to my era to live the life fate has in store. He can vouch for that.
Oh, someone else knows some Zaw.
I'm glad I'm not too late.
Mickey!
Just grab Sora so we can go. I can't stop them for long.
Okay. Mickey!
I said hands off. How can you be moving?
Oh no. Are you?
Be gone.
He's all like, hey, did I ever mention my Keyblade can control time? So using stop magic on me, not the greatest idea.
This is intense. Finally another...
This furthers my theory that this is definitely like old Xehanort past self, because he still has a Keyblade.
Yeah, he's not dark yet.
Well, not as dark.
Yeah. He hasn't given his heart to darkness, maybe.
Ah, great. You slowed me down. Ice Barrage isn't terrible, but I think something else would have been better.
Yeah, for two slots, no.
We should have put Fire Auto Bursting.
Yeah.
However, Dark Slicer is still doing the heavy lifting. Actually, it's not bad. Remember, it hits from quite a ways away. And this command style is messing him up. Although I'm not exactly sure what has happened. See, they're both thunder. That probably wasn't the best idea either. Hey, you got a little whip there. Oh, shit. Whew. If only he had more time. Okay, you gotta stop that doing that. This is bad. Yep. Yep, that got real bad real fast. See, I
can't. I'd say take it out.
Yeah. Where's that gonna put us?
Beginning of skippable cutscenes?
Yeah, I guess so. Faraga Burst, right?
Yeah, that was a nice one.
Do we want to like? Hold on, let's just consider something else for a sec here.
Items.
Aha. Never underestimate items. How about 11 elixirs? Oh, we only get to take 2 in at a time, though.
Yeah, not worth it. Not worth it.
So we only get to take... We can take 4 high potions. 3 mega potions.
Not worth it.
Just cure?
Yeah.
How about one of the other Kiragas?
Yeah.
Yeah? Maybe? Just give that a shot. I messed it up. See, I didn't use a stylus. I know this. Stuff's not charged. Is that from before?
Yeah, I believe so.
Bullshit. Yeah, that's probably more effective. Plus, it's just it's way more disrupting. Damn.
That attack's really cool. The Gravisa one's cool as well, but not a boss technique.
Yeah, that's way better. Slow motion dark splicer. I timed that really badly. Although that worked out. Yeah, slow motion shield lasts longer too. Counterattack time. That's not disrupting him so much anymore, huh? Frame rate. I seem to be invincible during the fire, but not during like other stuff. Can't lock onto him right now. There we go. Fire! Okay, I got it on second try. I'm 100% sure what I'm supposed to do. All right, destroy the clock. God, this really needs to finish it. I don't have enough time for another Kiraga. That's super tense.
That was a good one.
That's super, super tense. Because it's like, Xehanort has infinite health. You have to stir the clock. That's... That was my mistake the first time. And if you don't defeat him within a certain period of time, the battle just rewinds.
Are you okay, Riku?
Yeah. Thanks, Mickey.
My 12 selves would welcome me here on this day, and I would return a complete person. It is the future which lies beyond my sight.
Why are you doing this?
In ancient times, people believed that light was a gift from an unseen land by the name of Kingdom Hearts. But Kingdom Hearts was safeguarded by its counterpart, the Keyblade. Warriors vied for that precious light, thus beginning the Keyblade War. The violent clash shattered the Keyblade into 20 pieces, 7 of light and 13 of darkness. And the only real Kingdom Hearts was swallowed by the darkness. Never to surface again. I once tried to create my own pure light and darkness to forge the Keyblade, but the attempt ended in failure. In my eagerness, I had lost sight of the correct way to achieve my goal. I acted rashly. I can admit that now.
What you did back then, your mistakes, changed the destinies of 3 of my friends.
Ah, but destiny has never left to chance. I merely guided them to their proper places. The broken boy who failed to be the blade, the misguided master who sacrificed herself for a friend, and the feckless youth who became my new vessel.
I couldn't find a way to save them. But I wanted to believe that their sacrifice stopped you for good. Why? How was I so blind? I should have seen it as soon as Maleficent started gathering the 7 princesses apart.
Yes. They were all my doing. I used the evil fairy to find 7 pure lights for me, just as I prepared 13 vessels to fill with pure darkness.
But you failed. Sora stopped you in your tracks on both counts.
Yes, he did. That dull, ordinary boy. A Keyblade wielder so unlike any I have ever seen. However, have not abandoned my ambitions. The seven guardians of light and the 13 seekers of darkness.
Seven guardians of light? Well, for Keyblade wielders, there's me and Riku and Sora, and my three missing friends, that's six. Then the seventh would be... That means the 13 Seekers of Darkness.
Yes, little king. Perceptive. But Sora and another on your list belong to me now. And that puts you three guardians short. But worry not. All of the pieces are destined to appear. Your seven lights, just like my 13 darknesses, whose final clash will beget the prize I seek. The Keyblade! But first, the 13 darknesses shall be united. All the seats have been filled, and now the last vessel shall bear my heart like the rest.
No! Sora!
Supposed to be here.
Promises to keep. I'll always be there to get my friends back.
What? Bad timing?
You had your perfect little script, but you kind of forgot to write the sequel. Now, let's find out what happens.
What now, you old coot? Our time is up.
My name's... whatever. Axel. Fine. Now let's get out of here.
Right!
Once your lights and my darknesses have joined together.
Kind of ended fast.
Hmm.
Oh, well, it's been about three... It's been 30 seconds. Well, I guess we're out of time. That didn't account to be 10 seconds off schedule. Crap.
Hmm.
7 lights. 13 darknesses. Master Xehanort has been busy.
Aw, Sora. Don't tell me your heart's sleeping too.
No, Mickey. This affliction is not the same.
Can we do anything for him?
In your mark of mastery exam, you were to unlock 7 sleeping keyholes. By doing so, you would awaken those worlds from their prison of slumber, and also acquire the power to free a heart from its sleep. Riku, you unlocked those keyholes within Sora's dreams. Therefore, it stands to reason that you now have the power to awaken Sora's heart.
You want him to dive back into Sora's sleep? But, Master, Sora's heart is down in the darkest abyss. If Riku's not careful, he might just get trapped down there with him. No, I'll go instead.
And perhaps you may even succeed, Mickey. But there is no denying Riku stands the better chance, having dived into Sora's heart as long as he has.
Mickey, I really appreciate it, but I'll go wake Sora up.
Riku!
Look at his face, sleeping like nothing's wrong, like there's nothing to even worry about. He's always been like that. The three of us would agree to work on the raft, and then this guy would go take a nap on the beach. You see, it's my job to keep him on his toes. Besides, what kind of Keyblade Master sleeps through his tests? I'm doing it for me too. Sora saved me once. And I heard him call my name. He needs me.
There's something real strong that binds us to each other. Even in the darkness, you can reach him. All you gotta do is follow that connection.
Gee, we're all connected to Sora.
You're silent!
And if the darkness gets you, I promise I'll bail you out. Dark Rescue's my middle name.
Guys, thank you. Sora and I will be back soon.
Secret dive. There we go, Chainsaurus. Uh-oh. Evil Sora's.
Yeah.
can't get them while they have that blue barrier up. I missed that, Sora. Two more Soras. Interesting sequence. Diving straight into Sora's heart.
This abyss. Am I in Sora's dream?
See this coming?
Not like this.
Defeat the armored Ventus nightmare. I don't even know where he is. He doesn't have a whole lot of health, actually. This battle's over. Where is he? Oh, what the? It's the thing from the PSP game. Shot locked me! And I'm not sure what I was supposed to do.
He definitely shot locked you.
He just shot locked me.
Like, actually, that's exactly how it works in the PSP game.
Yeah.
But oppositely. Have you had that before?
Yeah. I just. For some reason, I didn't do a very good job defending against it. Despise not going so as well as last time. Yay, invisible walls! What level am I again? Like 38? 40?
Almost 40, maybe 40.
We got doubling going on here. That might be useful. Although my dream meters disappeared. When I'm in this white area, I don't have dream meters. He's done. You have to just time it a bit better. Don't just mash. Although I did not, I just slowly mashed. Like press, and that seemed to work okay that time.
Nice.
What is it that you're so afraid of? Huh?
What do you say, Davos? And what if I were to tell you there are correct answers?
I've heard that before, so I believe you.
Excuse me. What do you think is the... Just think about Kingdom
Hearts.
Causing
someone to be hurt?
You think that would be your answer?
Yeah.
Losing something that's important.
Losing something that's important. Roxas? No. Wait.
is the one thing you care about more than anything else?
Hearing their voices back to back, there's a huge difference between the voice acting done for Roxas and Ventus.
What is it that you care about most?
Yeah.
My friends.
My close friends? That'd be your answer?
Go with Kingdom Hearts, yeah.
Bingo!
Yeah.
My close friends. What is going on?
Sora!
Those 10 pixels didn't look like Sora to me.
Who are you?
Riku, what do you wish?
More questions. All right. I wish...
What do you think, Titus?
I think it's one of the top two ones. To protect my friends would just be like going along with the other one. But he did say losing something important was bad. So, I don't know.
What does he wish for? He wishes to protect his friends, he wishes to recover something important, or he wishes to heal the pain from the past.
Yeah, probably wishes to heal... I don't know.
Sora, I believe, wishes to heal the pain from the past.
Okay.
But the answer is to recover something important.
Yeah, okay.
To recover something important that I lost.
Although that I lost is an important part that I feel should have been attached to there. Well, that's a little eerie. Xehanort was standing in that exact spot at the beginning of the game.
What's this?
You were not the visitor I expected.
Nice.
Diz! I mean, Ansem the Wise. What are you doing here?
Perhaps I wanted to atone for events of the past, even if no apology can undo the harm I have wrought. I felt that I ought to leave at least something behind. So I digitized myself and my research and hid them within Sora.
So this is data?
Yes. A clue, I hope. To finding yourselves or your lost friends in your hour of need. The heart has always been quick to grow. Each exposure to light, to the natural world, to other people, shapes this most malleable part inside of us. Nobodies are not different from us in that manner. Sora was the only one able to return to his human form without destroying his nobody. That is a statement to the love in his heart for other people and the bonds that tie them together. Perhaps he has the power to bring back the hearts and existences of those connected to him. To recreate people we thought were lost to us forever. Our most precious treasures. Even an empty puppet. The trees of the forest. And the petals on the wind. There are hearts around us everywhere we look. And it does not take superhuman powers to see them. Surely we remember, as children, the way our hearts made everything seem so shiny and perfect. Sora has a heart like that. Uncorrupted, willing to see the good before the bad. When he sees the heart in something, it then becomes real. When a connection seems broken, he may have the power to mend it. He has touched countless hearts. He has accepted them, and he has saved them. And some of those hearts have never left him, whether they fell into darkness or were trapped then, whether they sleep in the darkness of Sora's heart, or were welcomed into its warmth. They can be saved. All Sora needs to do is be himself and follow wherever it is that his heart takes him. It is the best and the only way. The rest is in there.
All right. Thanks. Thank you.
Of course. Now, why is it that you are here?
I kind of need to wake Sora up.
Don't tell me he's going to sleep again.
Yeah. What'll I do with him?
What, indeed? Never fear. Sora is safe.
Huh?
He's not here. You see, by defeating the nightmare imprisoning Sora, you freed him.
Huh? You mean the Sora wrapped in that black phantom?
Then you came here, and you were questioned by three young people. That was the final key to awaken him. Sora is awake. You can go home now.
Really? Thank you.
Told me your name.
It's Riku. Tea party.
You're safe, Riku!
Oh, never mind. You okay? Feeling alright?
Yeah. I've never been better. I was watching what was going on in my dream. And I could hear your voice the whole time. Thanks, Riku. Thanks, everybody.
Whoa!
Yes,
oh, yeah!
My
did we pass the test?
You performed truly admirably, both of you. More than anything, I am grateful to have you both back from Xehanort's deception unharmed. And I am grateful to Lee, whose spontaneous actions turned the tides. I am also deeply sorry for failing to perceive the danger and throwing you headlong into a perilous test. This experience has revealed many hidden truths, and we must gird ourselves for the great clash with darkness that lies before us. I believe we need a new Keyblade Master, one with a new kind of power. Sora and Riku, you both deserve the honor. However, one of you braved the realm of sleep again to unlock the final keyhole and save a friend. Riku, I name you our new true Keyblade Master.
Way to go, Riku!
Yeah?
I knew you were gonna pass with flying colors! This is just so awesome!
Gee, Sora, you're kind of acting like it's you that passed.
I told you Sora's coming with some practice.
Hey!
Really? I'm a Keyblade Master?
Congratulations, Riku!
Thank you, Mickey. I owe it to my friends.
I'll catch up with you in no time flat.
What? You want to be a Keyblade Master?
Yeah. I mean, I came here to learn how to wield one.
You?
Hey, thanks for the vote of confidence. You know I was gonna come swooping in, Keyblade in hand. But I just couldn't get mine to materialize. Must be in the snap of the wrist or something. Oh.
Really?
Okay.
Yep.
Do you have to go?
Well, I did doze off. I just have some stuff to take care of.
I want one more, too?
Yeah, I won't be long.
Be careful.
Very careful.
Right, see you soon.
Kingdom Hearts 3D.
So was that ending there setting up for another game before Kingdom Hearts 3?
No. If Nomura is to be believed, the next one should be Kingdom Hearts 3, but before that we're going to have some remakes. The HD remakes and stuff. It's either one or two HD remakes and then hopefully Kingdom Hearts 3. So we're still looking at like 2015 or later.
What would it be released on?
What, the new ones?
Yeah.
PS3 and or something else, but probably just PS3. I had to guess. Maybe PS4. Who knows? Well, I know the HD 1.5 thing that's coming out in Japan at least is going to be a PS3 thing.
They fixed the platforming in the first one.
Maybe. But it'll at least be some kind of final mix version.
That would be awesome. Keyblade wielding.
So let's what's the list of seven now? Riku, Sora, Axel, Aqua, then
with what we know. Riku, Sora, Lee, Axel,
Mickey.
Is Kyrie Wheeler?
Actually, if we're counting Aqua Van, that kind of solves everybody. We're assuming Terra is lost because Ansem and Xemnas exist?
Yeah.
But I'm not 100% sure. Maybe we can save him too. Roxas potentially, but I mean, having Roxas, Sora, and Ven, that's like one too many of like the same person, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
I know. Let's just say Sora. I don't think Sora is going to be allowed to dual wield unless that's the case. I don't know, but the dual wielding comes from Shion. But then Shion too. Is Shion going to have a Keyblade? There's a lot of potential light Keyblade wielders.
So many different Xehanorts there.
Peg Leg Pete, that's literally his name.
He did have a peg leg to fit the power description.
Jesse McCartney played both Ventus and Roxas. Yes. So you see the glowing letters? I've got to try to get all of them. Tagos, you tell me when you think you've figured it out. Oh shit.
No, man.
Anything?
Mark. No. Unlocked. Secret music? No. Message.
Very good. So, secret message unlocked. Let's just actually see if I can actually do it. If you miss one gold letter... Oh god. Okay, that one didn't have one, right? I really don't need stress in my credit sequences. Alright. Can now put the console down. There's another hidden message here, by the way. Should I just say it now so no one has to, like, be distracted and try to figure out the message the whole time? Or do you want me to, or do you want to try to figure it out?
Is it using just those words?
No. It takes the whole credit sequence that remains.
Yeah, go ahead. Sir.
It starts with this.
Okay.
This is not the secret message that I just unlocked, by the way. I don't think it is, at least.
This one.
X is an L. This light, this Lee, Ellie, this Lee, still Lee.
Leave?
The lead? This leads. So this leads somewhere. I fell off a building twice! Ha 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 ha! He did, right?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. This leads to... Man, this tea is sticking around for a long time. This leads to...
So unobvious. Kingdom Hearts 3?
Yeah, that's right. That is exactly right. This leads to Kingdom Hearts 3. Although the 3 is a little debatable. But it definitely says this leads to Kingdom Hearts. And the message doesn't really make sense unless you say 3. But now that we have the video recorder, we can find out once and for all if it really does say 3 or not. Maybe we might not find out during the live stream. But we certainly will later. So we're dumb. King Dom.
And this isn't the secret message you unlocked?
No. There's another different secret message. And if we did everything right, and or my save from my previous file still has the video unlocked, we have a hidden movie too. Big Leg Pete. And some Secret of Darkness dress as well. Actually, he dresses the same as normal Xehanort.
Yeah.
Plain old Xehanort. Okay, so tell me, is there a three in the background that Sora and... Look, do they make a three?
Yeah.
They make a three? As they make a three? Yeah. So they make the holes in the three, and then you get a Roman numeral three look out of it?
Yeah, that's...
That's the deal?
Definitely.
Okay, I've never actually noticed that before. I thought I was looking for a silhouette in the background or something, but using them making the three makes way more sense.
Mm.
And I can... I'll believe that. I'll allow it.
Mm-hmm.
Unlock a secret message. We get to see it right now? Nope.
Good. I was hoping this world was still here. But where are they?
This scares me to no end. Why are the Dream Eaters in the real world now? This does not bode well for Kingdom Hearts 3.
Thanks! You're the best!
No.
No.
No! Still not the secret movie. But Ventus is still waiting. Most use slow motion wall kick, and then it just lost count. Most used toy, best for spirit friend, most used link. Oh yeah, that comet was used a lot early on. We got 85% of the spirits though, that's not bad. I don't know what spirit smiles means. Killed nearly 3,000 enemies. 26 hours, that was a huge improvement over my first time. Don't know what took me so long.
Treasure hunting.
This time was much faster. Yes. Although I already have one, so now I have two completed files. Alright, so let's load the file. So yeah, we beat Kingdom Hearts 3D.
Nice.
No distance. So we're back with Sora shortly before going to fight Xemnas.
Is that what you just saved?
Yeah, like if I go over and if I go this way, I'll go fight Xemnas.
Okay.
Which is the only real place the game can really leave off. But now it is a completed save. So if we go into reports, first let's look at the trophy shelf. So the trophies I've got is I beat the story, I beat the story in proud mode, I've got 2,000 drop points, I have taken first place in every Flick Rush Cup in my other file. We didn't do that in this one. We decided that was a bad idea.
Mm-hmm.
That's probably what took up all that other time, actually. Proof you have taken out 2,500. Again, we almost took out 3,000 this game, so that doesn't seem too... If you just fight everybody, you'll do it. Proof you have amassed 5,000 money. We had like 11,000 at some point. Spirit Affinity level, special portal, and secret portals. A ton of points in dive mode. If you get all gold, you'll be well on your way towards this. Somehow I haven't killed 1,000 enemies with flow motion. Well, actually, I can see how that, because I don't use flow motion in combat all that much.
Yeah.
Found every last treasure. I like this one. Proof you have at least one of every spirit. Proof you finished the story on critical mode. That's hard mode. Proof you defeated 50 enemies using reality shift. That's easy. Proof you've linked with your spirit at least 50 times, also super easy. Proof you've maxed out every stat-boosting ability. Proof you have saved at least 20 photos while bonding with spirit. Again, that's super easy if you just want to take the time and take a bunch of photos. Like, if you are short on trophies, remember, I think you need 5 on proud mode and 7 on normal mode to get the secret ending. And only 3 on critical mode. Which means you'll get these 3 automatically. 1, 2, and 3. So if you're playing critical mode. I don't think you can play critical mode off the bat, so it's not even something you have to worry about. But what do we come here for? Where do you think the stuff would be, story? No.
Like videos?
No. Oh, mementos probably, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well, there's Secret Movie. Where's Secret Message? Let's start with Secret Message. That's gotta be in the report somewhere. Where is that? It isn't Story. No, it's not in Story.
Glossary.
Yeah, very good. The past will be reawakened as a new number in never-before-seen detail. Prepare yourself for the awakening of the next number. Now, I've interpreted this two different ways. This is either talking about the remakes as a new number. 1.5 is a different than Kingdom Hearts 1. And that in never-before-seen detail, HD remake. To me, this is talking about the HD remakes. Otherwise, it's talking about how Kingdom Hearts 3 will be on next-gen consoles. Which also makes sense. A new number in never-before-seen detail. Kingdom Hearts 3 on next-gen consoles. So either way, it's talking about the 1.5 remix or Kingdom Hearts 3. I don't know which. Probably, maybe both. Open to interpretation. Now, secret movie. Another Guardian of Light.
This world is just too small.
Sora's late. Do you think he's okay? Gorsh, we sure hurried back to Radiant Garden. And now Master Yen Sid's sending Riku away, too, on some mystery errand. You think we'll ever get to do something important?
I hope so.
Oh, welcome back, Riku. Wait!
The Keyblade Wars of yore plunged the true Kingdom Hearts into darkness. And the Keyblade was shattered. But the light still shining in the hearts of children rebuilt the world that we know today. And the light from the broken Keyblade was then divided into seven. To protect the number of pure hearts in the world.
Seven pure lights. They're the princesses of heart.
Indeed. Those seven pure hearts form the very source of all light in the world. If they are lost, the world will again give way to shadow. Thus, even if we deliberately avoid finding our seven lights to avert another Keyblade war, Xehanort will still target the seven princesses in order to forge the Keyblade.
So, there's gonna be a clash between seven lights and 13 darknesses? And there's nothing we can do to avoid triggering the Keyblade war?
To protect the seven pure hearts, we will need seven lights strong enough to stand against the 13 darknesses.
So we're missing one Guardian of Light. Riku! You're back!
That's right. Master Yen Sid, I brought you the guest you asked for, but you never said why.
I have come to learn that you too can wield a Keyblade. I'm glad you are here.
So you were right, Kairi.
I wonder if you'll play as her.
So, yeah, that makes me wonder what kind of game Kingdom Hearts 3 is going to be. It will have seven playable characters?
Three droppable characters is what we're looking at here.
No dropping characters?
Yeah.
Let's drop between seven characters. Why stop at three? Come on. People are going to want to play as Axel. Or Lee. Or whatever. Alright, this game is one more kind of major thing up its
sleeve. You get to play as Axel 1.1 game, right?
Kingdom Hearts 358 over 2 days. You can play as him in like mission mode. Yeah. Which was that like either single player or multiplayer mode, depending on how you want to play. So there's one hidden boss that unlocks after you complete the game. And I will show it, but I will not and have no intention of actually beating it or even making a true, proper attempt at it. It's just not my thing. I'm way underleveled. I was a bit underleveled to beat the game. And just doing this takes it to the extreme. Let's see how powerful I am for this area, though. I am a little curious about that. Pretty powerful. Everything explodes.
Big like Pete.
It's actually, this is like a character named Julian or something from the old Disney stuff.
Another one.
Really, you do?
Black and white?
Yeah. I don't know the thing, so really, you do?
Well, I mean, I've seen the character before.
Come on, I want to go that fast. I got stuck. I'm gonna give it one more shot. I want to get some damage in. That's our goal. Remember, Teclis, get noticeable damage in.
I don't know how much defense this guy has.
That's a good question. But I bet he doesn't have more health bars than the game has health bars. There we go. We did it. Okay, get out of there. Oh God, Zoro. Oh God, he's done. That's a mega flare for the damage to be shown. See, it's just way more strategy and blocking and stuff. I'm sure this is a very technical fight and isn't all that difficult if you just do it properly. That's really the most. Most Kingdom Hearts bosses can be broken down that way.
Pretty much.
You can also just brute force them, and it's not the hardest thing to do. But it does. There is a difficulty curve where that just stops working. And this is it. But already a huge improvement from the first try. Let's see if we can do a full life bar damage. I just totally destroyed my Ars Arcanum. Oh, God! You see, if I was just a bit more careful with my two cures and stuff, I could probably actually do this fight. I just don't have the patience to do it now. We're at the end of the marathon, and it's over. There we go. Waiting for my cures to recover, and that's it. But you get the idea. So that's the hidden boss that comes in.
I'd rather fight Sephiroth, but that's cool too.
Yeah. Anyway, the chat's pointing out that it's not really the hardest fight in the world. It's even not the highest strategy fight. But
it's a bonus.
Compared to the rest of the stuff in Kingdom Hearts 3D, it's a bit different.
Mm-hmm.
And again, I'm sure being higher than level 40 or whatever would help. Let's just see. What level was I actually? Level 40. I'm sure being higher than level 40 helps. So, with that, let's see if we can get back to a title screen of sorts. No, right? No easy way to do that?
Exit.
That'll just take us somewhere. Anyway, that ends the Kingdom Hearts 3D Dream Drop Distance Marathon. Any final thoughts, Douglas, about the game or the direction's going?
Started off really vague as to what was really going on. Last probably 4 to 5 hours, it's just kind of like, okay, so this is it.
Yeah, Nomura definitely watched Inception at some point before making this game. Probably immediately before making this game.
Mm.
Or at least immediately before writing the last few hours.
It all works, for the most part.
Yeah, for the most part. There's definitely a bit of retconning. He's taking a lot of his ideas that he just kind of threw out there randomly and either finally, like, honest question. Do you think in Kingdom Hearts 1 he had any of this thought out? Like, not like even in the remotest slight bit?
Down to the finite...
Do you think he was just clever enough to leave himself openings to expand?
Do I think that he thought about the one Master Xehanort time travel? No.
Yeah, and the whole, like, well, if you give up your body, you can time travel, and then there's the young one, and then the guy in the cloak, and
I don't think he got that far.
He possessed Riku, remember that? Hmm. Either way, you're right, it works. And it's spelled out, like, but the problem I have with Halo 4 is it made some story stuff that you either had to justify yourself, or do outside reading. Like, it expected you to do outside reading if you wanted a full understanding of what was going on. Whereas, even in this game, it went crazy. It went some directions that you couldn't have thought it. But it at least spelled it out and made it obvious what it was attempting to do. Even repeated itself a few times.
Yeah, which is good.
Yeah, no, it wasn't too much. But yeah, overall, I say this game ranks pretty high up there. Not above Kingdom Hearts 1, and not above Kingdom Hearts 2. It is above 350 over 2 days. It is probably above Chain of Memories and Re-Chain of Memories.
Birth by Sleep?
See, that's the one I'm having trouble. I don't think it's better than Birth by Sleep. Birth by Sleep is probably better than this game. It at least is more varied and has less annoying things in it. The closest thing... Shotlocks. Shotlocks are awesome. As proven by
yeah,
the Ventus Armored Nightmare.
I'd say I'd like to...
That was unexpected the first time that happened to me. I'm like, alright, I got you. We got this. Okay, you want to square off one more... Wait, what? Wait, that's the lock. That's the shot lock sound. No! You're not allowed to do this. This is not that game. We are not on a PSP. What? And then I died because I didn't know what to do.
Mm.
A lot like there, except this time I kind of knew what to do. I just didn't do it right.
Are you on top of this thing?
That? No. No, that's about the invisible ceiling height level. But remember, we have glide now. Very leisurely glide. That's cool. You don't ever actually... You can just keep going. You never actually touch the floor. This is new, right? Before glide, when you hit the ground, you would stop.
How fast do you run?
Like, compared to this?
Yeah. Probably the same.
A little bit faster, I think. I think I'm running slightly faster, but it's hard to say. Yeah, it's about the same. You're right. Alright, well, with that final discovery.
Together!
We'll see you all next time! Lasers into the sky!